Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, we're gonna paint this large glob painting here. It's a palette that we're gonna use. And here I premix the colors for the end of painting. Basically also the final layer for the background. Yeah, I establish here the shape of the cloud. And then I basically, while also painting side of the painting, the edges here, I build up the connection from the lighter color that we have on the bottom part here to the more darker color on the top, and I do it very loose way at the beginning. I mix the color with some linseed oil and I apply it roughly in the beginning, then I start to blend it, as you can see. It's a very soft brush. And I try to really get this thing looking like really real, more or less. Therefore, really took a long time to blend the two colors together. Then here I basically build up the lower end, this painting here. Basically just grayish colors, a bit more darker to the left side. Then I mix the second layer while the painting is drying. And you see we have lots of purplish, grayish tones here. Yeah, then I start to build up the whole thing with some flat brushes, some soft ones, some harder ones like these nose here. I start to build up the cloud details on the upper part here. And you see me painting not even a minute in, and I already start to mix some new color for this special part here. And I also use just a little hint of color, more or less. Again, this famous dry brush technique here. And yeah, you might wonder, he mixed all those colors beforehand and now he starts to mix another one. And yes, this is another lesson that you need to pick up here when it comes to painting clouds. You always have to adjust the palette that you use according to the painting that you have in front of you. In this case, I have some blue tones and some grayish tones, and I realized for this part of the cloud, the color that I mixed was just a bit off. So I had to remix it, get a bit more on the bluish tone here. Yeah, and you see, the upper part is basically kind of melting into the background, and this part here now is a bit more prominent, a bit more to the foreground. And I think this is a very important thing when it comes to painting clouds, and that you make sure you have parts of the clouds that really basically melts into the background, like we have here on the upper part, parts that you can hardly see when you step away from the painting, but they really make a big difference, especially in contrast to the other parts where the clouds are more dominant, coming more to the foreground. And yeah, I'm using here again the famous dry brush technique. And you see, I'm toying around with the thickness of the color. In this place here, I apply the color thicker to get the underpainting a bit better covered. And on this part here, I basically use a tiny brush and hardly any color on the brush. And this really helps to to save you time for mixing too many different colors that you have to use for this part here. Yeah, you basically just have to thin down the color on the surface as much as you need for getting in the volume that you need. Same goes for this part here. I'm slapping on the color, roughly. Adjusting it while I'm going. A bit more to the grayish part. And I grab a very soft brush and start to blend the whole thing. And with this I build up the volume on this cloud here. And okay, this is my way of doing it. It's a very... How can I put it? It takes a while to build up the thing. You need to know where the volume is. You need to know where you... have to put in the volume, where you have to put in thinner colors, where you have to fade out of the clouds a bit more. And yeah, this really is something you... that of course doesn't come natural. More or less. And my tip for this is just follow your material, the reference material that you're going to use for this whole thing. And then you build it up slowly. And like here, for example, I grab some lighter color and give it the whole thing more shape, more volume. And this process basically repeats itself until I'm satisfied, and the paint is still not dry, and this may look a bit silly, a bit off, a bit tedious, but I think this is a way to really don't do too many errors, that you just don't have to correct the whole thing over and over again. And it's slowly, a very slow way of building up clouds, but with these colors that I use, these water mixable oils, you basically have all the time in the world to build up a part like this. The color needs still hours to dry, and therefore you can basically toy around with it for a very long time. I will show you the rest of the painting process here in time lapse. I mean, basically it repeats itself, applying the color, getting in the volume, readjusting the whole thing, getting lighter, getting darker. And you see here again color fading out to the background. I mean the cloud fading out to the background. And other parts that really stand proud and dominant. And this again is the key, I think, to this piece here. To make it look realistic. Adding some more details here and there. And we are finished.